In this video, we're gonna soak Lake Superior agates in mineral oil for a week. And the reason why is because when agates are dry, they look like this. But when they're wet, they look like that. And that looks a lot better. So by taking some dry Lake Superior agates and soaking them in mineral oil for a week, we can extend that wet look for months. Let's look at some of the agates we'll be soaking in mineral oil. So here's our candidates, and I really think that these are going to benefit from a longer lasting wet look. Here's a pair that could be brother sister agates. They got the same color and same kind of banding in them. Pretty cool. A few with some really nice bands. Not sure if it'll make much of a difference with this one, but I'm excited to see how it plays out. Got this guy going in the batch as well. Here's a couple with some good quartz going on in there that I'm really looking forward to see how the oil soaks into the quartz. And a couple of really banded and beautiful Lake Superior agates. This one's got a lot of bands hiding throughout it, and I'm really looking forward to seeing how this one fares. So, let's get it ready. So one of the methods that people have used for soaking agates in mineral oil is to heat them up, and I'm gonna test just doing them at room temp to see if it makes a difference that way and how long it lasts. So I'm gonna be doing a follow-up video in the future to see how these fare with the oil. But till then, we're gonna put them in this mason jar, fill it with oil, and let them sit for a week. So let's fill it all up. So we got this filled up with all the agates, and it's almost comical that the amount of mineral oil that I had was the perfect amount to fill this jar. So now comes the fun part. We wait. We'll see you all in 7 days. They're still soaking in oil, and you know what? After about an hour of them soaking in there, I already saw a difference. So we probably didn't need to leave them in there as long as we did, but it is what it is. So now we get the fun part of getting them out of here and getting the oil wiped off and all that fun stuff. It's gonna be an oopy goopy mess. Let's get it started. We got them all wiped off, got all the oil rubbed in, and we can touch them now with ease, with not getting oil all over our fingers. They look spectacular. I'm so excited to show you all of these. There's a few of them that are mind-blowing better. I'm so pumped about this. So one of the first ones I wanted to show you was this guy that had the light quartz in there, impossible amethyst, and the back here. It's very shiny. That's just rubbed in. And look at that, how that purple popped. It's absolutely amethyst on that carnelian. I don't know if you'd consider that a nodule, but that is really, really cool. These two, same thing. I rubbed in the oil as much as I possibly could. These just look wet now. So beautiful. It's got some shadow banding. You can see it right there. Pretty cool. And these two, I wasn't too sure if it would make a huge difference. And, well, I don't really think it did. I don't think you need to do mineral oil on limonite stained agates. But this stuff looks pretty cool right here. And then the details in this guy really did pop a lot better right here. But the top and bottom didn't make a huge difference. But it's got some really beautiful details in here that showed up that I didn't really notice before. That is really cool. It almost looks purple. I wouldn't say amethyst, but it looks purple. That is so cool. I'm very happy with how this one turned out. This is one of my favorite Lake Superior agates. It is so neat. I actually found it about 5 feet away from this one. And I love how the limonite drips in through there. Really great bands. already kind of showed you this guy, what it would potentially look like. Looks about the same. Quartz is just soaked in with that mineral oil. Some bands on the outer rim here really started to pop, and that white really, really pops. And this guy had so many fractures in it. I was really excited for this one. And now it looks so good. These bands are some of my favorites. I love the reds and the whites that are popping there. It looks so much better than before. I was pretty excited about this guy. Most of it is just nodule husk, but there's this one part right here I was really looking forward to. And it always looks so just bland dry, and now much better. Much, much better. And these bands in this little area right here popped a little bit too. So that was cool to see. I was pretty surprised at this one, at how much the quartz soaked in that mineral oil. Look at this line right here. That is so neat. It's got some banding going on up here. And I always knew this one was really beautiful. And I'm pretty sure that this is a sagonite agate. And by the way, it has pink on the husk here, which is extremely rare for Lake Superior agates. But the details that showed up after the soak, right there, unbelievable. It's almost like the base of the sagonite sprays. I've never seen that before. It is so cool. And on to the two big ones. I was really pumped about this one because this is one of my favorite Lake Superior agates. It's probably my favorite one. And I always loved getting this one wet and taking a peek at it. And now I can just look at it in its full glory. And this is one of those Lake Superior agates I'm never going to do anything to. It is going to stay as is forever. So beautiful. Looks much better. It looked pretty good before, but it definitely looks better now. And this guy right here is one that I was absolutely amazed with the details that showed up after just an hour of it soaking, like right here. Some of these details that came in, these bands that showed up. It's going to be hard to see with the glare, but this is shadow banding all along here. When you rotate it, you can see it right there. Watch right here. See that? How cool is that? But the bands that popped over here were really, really cool. I knew there was bands in here and up in here, but it really came up and through here. But right here, this is what really popped. This whole area is showing every detail. Oh, this is a close second behind this guy. And then watch as this red comes down. It's almost like iron stained quartz in this pocket. It is like red quartz. It's so cool looking. This is probably the one that had the best before and after with the mineral oil soak. Oh, so cool. And that husk. Oh, absolutely phenomenal. Well, I had a super fun time with this project. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you can do me a huge favor, click on one of the videos that pops up on the screen right now. Thanks for watching. Bye.